Okay, thanks for coming back to the channel. So, the live stream was a bit of a bust. I recorded almost an hour, and when I watched it back, it was really choppy, a really poor performance. Now, some people actually still dialed in and watched, so thanks for those people for just spending time watching the worst, choppiest channel footage ever. I'm just recording this now. I am still in the same location, so I'm about 100 metres away, 70 to 100 metres away from my PC. My PC is connected 5 gigahertz wireless to my router. My PC spec is a Ryzen 7 2700X. The graphics is a RX 5500 XT 8 gig. So, not the highest spec machine. Now, it can run BeamNG Drive at normal settings, but now this can only do at low settings at 540p. So it's running 1080p indoors. I am streaming it via Sunshine, since it's an AMD card, and Moonlight installed on the Steam Deck. So the connection out here, it's a mesh network. The connection is only about 50 megabits at peak. And that's download. Uploads, probably about 20 to 30 megabits. So not super fast. So on this, I had a bit of latency issues. Now I've tweaked the... It was already set to 720p for streaming, and I've tweaked the bitrate, the megabits that it was using. It was sitting at 10 megabits. I've just tweaked it down to about 7. Seems to be running pretty smooth now. So we're going to have a quick go of this. I'm not going to do all the stuff I did earlier in the stream, but I'm going to do this one because this is one that I think it's quite a good test, because there's a lot of trees, and you will see a little bit of kind of aberration where, you know, the texture quality is maybe not super good, but it still runs really well. The input is snappy. See, there was a little bit there where you probably picked up that the resolution dipped quite a bit there again. Now, not any worse than when I'm running it locally, but the difference being when you're running it locally, you're getting thick. Oh, I can't say that was very good driving on my part. Well, try that one more time. So, as I was saying, you're getting 540p when you run it natively, and you're getting about 30fps. Here I'm running 720. Well, it's running 1080p natively on the machine, and I'm streaming it at 720, so it's still higher resolution. Like I say, you got a little bit of graphical glitch in, but input 60fps, and it feels good. It feels faster than it does at 30, which is why when I crash, it makes it all the more embarrassing. So as you can see, that's a little bit pixely. I think, you know, it's absolutely playable. Get in there. Yes. Oh, back on the wheels. Get unpanned. No, it's going the other way now. I've still my wheel trims. I'll be coming at my pay. I think I've done more damage to my car than I did to his. Oh, he's going to get steamed, isn't he? Yes, that's right in a tree, surely. God, he saved it! See this AI, it's unbelievable. Oh yeah, I've got a bad wheel. Oh dear. Oh, no. That works. Come on. Oh. So I failed because I damaged the car too much. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. So, the reason I was testing this is, one, I wanted to see how Sunshine worked, since, you know, I was ruled out of using Moonlight because I had AMD. And the reason I had AMD was, you know, mostly down to price. And the reason I wanted to test Sunshine particularly now is because I have an absolute handheld coming in the post. I mean, it's been shipping for the last week and it's not actually left the factory yet, I don't think, but you know, I can't complain. I'm getting a DVT test, a DVT-2 unit, which is fantastic. This is as close as you're going to get to the final production version, I think, unless there's some major issues coming out of this, and I think Absolute are very proud of what they've done so far. Oh, here we go again. I shouldn't be allowed in a police car, really, should I? Yikes. So, getting to test this, I think I'm blown away that they've actually... I just asked, and they had a wee look at my channel, and they were like, yes, we'd like you to test one of our products, and fantastic. So, I'm now part of the Buddy program on their Discord channel, so if anyone's on the Discord channel watching this video, or what is going on with my driving? And have you got to start? Okay. So, as I was saying, if anyone's on the Discord channel and is following me, and they've got any content they would like, or anything they'd like to see tested on the DVT2 units, just drop me a comment on this video, speak to me on your Discord channel, go by Handheld Gaming on there, so feel free to get in touch. I'm working, well, loosely working, we've talked, me and one of the other buddies, they're getting a DVT1 unit, and I said it'd be quite cool if we could maybe do a bit of comparison of our experiences, so they're up for that, so hopefully that's something we can do. I mean, all this extra work, it's good. You know, it's kind of unpaid development, really, you're getting to get involved in with Absolute, and it's brilliant, actually. It feels a real honour to get involved, even in a small way. And as you can see, that's a little bit pixely, but, oh, look, it's so responsive. 60 FPS, feels great. Doesn't look great right now, but it feels great. Oh, he's going to crash all by himself, and so am I. He didn't crash as bad as me. See some of these short videos I make? They end up being quite long. Almost at 7 minutes now. I haven't even succeeded to complete this. That's all I wanted to do. I've done this in about 30 seconds before. Anyway, I'm quite impressed with how game streaming works. It's came a long way. Now, if I had a more solid connection, I think I'd have more solid connection if I just connected 5G right now. But that's kind of the aim. Ultimately, I would love to be able to do that. You know, downtime somewhere, just pop out the Absolute game stream to my PC at home. In fact, I would love to have something a bit more compact and more powerful. And I mentioned this in the game stream. I would love to get a wee partnership going with somebody like Minis Forum, because I've followed them from the beginning, and I have to admit, I've never bought any of their products, but I've always meant to. And I've kind of embarrassed myself that I haven't bought one of their products yet. And I think it might be on the horizon soon. And I would quite like to... There we go, that's worked. So, very playable. 60 FPS. Brilliant. So, as I was just saying there, before I sign off on the channel, I'd love to get involved with somebody like Minis Forum and do a little Wii U type setup. You've got your main CPU part sitting, you know, plugged into the TV, but you've got your separate remote screen. Oh, I've lost connection. You've got your separate remote screen where you're streaming, you know, sitting on the couch and maybe watching TV but playing a game at the same time, or, you know, and you can cart it off and go off to watch the kids play soccer or, you know, swimming lessons, and you can sit and actually hotspot and carry on playing. Seems like a great concept to me, and if it works, all the better. So, anyway, thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next video. And I hope this has been informational. Informational? Does that make sense? So here you go. 720p, 7 megabytes we'd run the video bitrate at. And that was running pretty well, I thought, up until we got disconnected. But I put that down to my Wi-Fi connection. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hopefully this footage is a bit sharper than the terrible live stream. I'm just going to leave the live stream set as private. Unless anybody wants to watch it, they can ask if they want to watch it, but really it'll just make your eyes bleed. So thanks for watching. If you're not subscribed, please do. Catch you next video and have a great weekend, everyone.